time now for the second part of the John Volpe Report. Brought to you by Max Vassell. Why is it you did stand-up last night? Brought to you by Max Vassell, the fitness, and Michael Evans, author of The Real Matrix. So you do stand-up last night. Yeah, it'd help if I did that.
Oh, yes. Hi. Yes, I did for my first time.
And it's like I'm loaded with one-liners now. I feel like I'm Henny yeah. Youngman, like, reincarnated.
So and it's great because it's correlating with my year anniversary of doing radio up here with you. It wouldn't have been possible without you.
Wait a minute. I have to just do this. Bless me, Father, for my sin. My last confession was 2 years ago on Ash Wednesday.
Really?
I think so, yeah.
Is it because you're that good?
No, it's because... it's because...
It's like,
I used to teach this stuff.
I haven't gone to confession in 5 years. I have not done one thing wrong.
Well, I keep telling, I have certain friends who are priests, and they know that if we're going to talk professionally, they need to clear an afternoon. They just do. Anyway, you should bring on the other guest.
Yes. So,
GP Lane. Good morning, Mr. Lane.
Good morning.
What do you want to be called?
I do prefer in these venues GP. But
No, that's okay.
Nobody remembers the two letters GP. They call me DJ, DT. It's kind of fun. But well, it is GP, as in Gerard Patrick.
Gerard.
Oh, okay. Because I was going to say, GP is like, that's how the Jeep got its name, general purpose vehicle.
I was always hoping that Jeep would give me a free one.
You would think, right, at the very least. And you would get your favorite model, not this little, what's the little tiny one they got now?
I don't know.
There's a little...
I do know it.
It's a
friend of mine has it. It's cute. It's a really cute little vehicle.
Yeah, but can you go over a dual?
I saw my dyslexic nod to one of my favorite authors, P.G. Wodehouse.
Oh, great stuff. He was very involved. I don't know if you know this, like local history. He was very involved with the founding the Bidewe home in West Hampton.
Oh.
I had no idea.
Yeah, he was very involved in that. Yep.
His stuff always made me laugh, and I do like laughing, like last night with Gianna.
Let me ask you a question, Mr. Lane.
Oh, which, by the way, GP, I've got Mike Reed up here.
You're under oath.
Michael Patrick Reed.
Did she really spend 10 minutes working over her poor, beloved mommy?
No, only 5.
All I can say is, she paid tribute in a humorous way.
She loved it. I wrote her. I said, Mom, listen, before you see the video.
Tell stories about her. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure she looks down at heaven from me, at me, and smirks and says, everything's a joke with you, Gerard.
Yeah,
she says, wait, you'll get here one day. Then I'll fix you up.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, right?
My mom could wait. She could lie in wait for decades and get you back for something.
Well, your mom is Sicilian, isn't she?
You know what? I don't know for sure, but I have to think that in our blood, that we've got Sicilian.
You got him because, well, first of all, the last name ending in a vowel.
Right.
Which is why I
No, but I mean, the
I still
sense,
can't believe you didn't know what Struffoli was.
I do know what Struffoli is, and I love it.
You have no idea what we went through here.
I just didn't know what it was called.
My mother was a great baker, and she made struffola. It was the one thing, I know she's going to strike me with a lightning bolt. It just was the worst thing. The squirrels wouldn't eat it. One day, a friend of mine brings me these light, airy, honey balls, and I go, what is this? And she went, it's struffola. I was like, no, struffola's little hard pellets. My mother was afraid of the hot boys.
I have a friend, this is no kidding, I have a friend now who will remain nameless, except to say that on his Thanksgiving table, besides the turkey, which comes out of the oven unharmed after 7 hours, there is a crystal decanter with syrup of Ipecac in the middle of the table. Flies tell them to fix the screen door, stuff like that.
Tell me about
you guys do an open mic night
every Wednesday night.
Where is this?
Okay, it is located in the Feather Hill Shopping Center on Route 25 in the town of Southold, and it's nestled in the corner. It's like a complex of shops. Mm-hmm. Robert's Jewelers is there, a Dunkin' Donuts is there, and a wonderful restaurant called Wednesday's Table. If you love a banh mi sandwich, go there. And it is the furthest building on the western side of the complex, and it's just reminiscent of an Irish pub. It has that same feel, friendly, really good products. They not only feature Long Island wines and beers, but they also have Guinness, say, and other libations. Oh, the other thing I like about the place is, although they don't serve food, they welcome you to bring
right.
a picnic
That's
or
pretty cool.
go to the pizzeria and bring some food in, and then just hang.
I had Lombardi's.
Wednesdays, we see a kind of like a sessions group. At the beginning of it, a guy will come down with his flute and mandolin, and they just kind of jam for a little while. And then as the performers start signing up, we then go into a 15-minute or three-song minimum set. And I welcome it all. We had a wonderful guy last night. His name was Michael Reed. Read some of his own poetry.
We've got him up here in the studio.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, I said we've got him
Jonna,
in the studio.
Jonna,
that was my fault. I'm sorry.
You interrupted him. He was being sarcastic.
I know. I'm sorry, GP.
No, it's okay. I wasn't being sarcastic. Sarcasm is the refuge of a weak wit.
Ooh.
I'm not having a great
Whoa.
Connection. For some reason, you're very yeah. low. Maybe it's the radio thing. So I am having a hard time hearing. So believe me, Gianna can interrupt any time she wants.
Oh, stop
She's
it, GP.
Delightful.
So yeah, we have Michael Reed up here in the studio to join us. And so, yeah, this young man read some of his poetry as well.
Yeah, and Lisa Dabrowski from LNG actually recited an original piece of poetry and then sang a really cool rendition of the old Nancy Sinatra song, These Boots Are Made for Walking.
Which I'm totally going to post on my Facebook.
By the way. You ever want to embarrass Lisa? You want to see Lisa blush? It's very easy to make Lisa Dabrowski blush.
I believe it.
How do you make her blush?
But you ever watch The Addams Family and Gomez goes kissing Morticia up the arm?
Yeah.
It's like, that does it.
You did that to her?
Oh, several times.
Oh, my God.
In public. Like at the Little Red Country Fair, I did that tour 2 years ago. I did it.
She's a very sweet and gentle.
She's a sweetheart. She really is. I love her to death.
Her talent's a great
But
deal.
She was up the
and
score.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
Miss Volpe, who's testing the waters of her comedic ability, has a natural timing and an astute observational skill.
Exactly.
I enjoyed it. And I encourage anyone, you want to tell a story, as long as you're not offending people, I'm into it. That's what an open mic is about. It's testing the water of your skills. Honing your craft a little bit. We had a guy last night. He just got up there and he sang Anything Goes, just a cappella.
That was great.
And I explored that sort of thing.
Oh, and that's, I think, is so great. You have such an open mind. And, I feel that you're approaching it correctly, being so open-minded and open-hearted about everything. And I'm curious, you know, Rocky's there, and Jean Merkel was talking about how this is sort of a reincarnation of Rocky's sessions at, you know, in Matatuck. Would you say that's accurate?
To a degree, in that sense of community, but not in the way it was run. I'm a little bit more structured than my good friend Rocky DeVello.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I do want everyone to have a chance.
Yeah, the guy's dead.
But, and that's one of the reasons that Rocky Sessions, he would defer to me, because it's easier for me to get up there and go, oh, thank you so much for coming down, and our next performer is.
Right.
Whereas Rocky, you know, would be distracted, that sort of thing, and somebody may not get to play. I want to make sure anybody that signs the list gets to play. I also want to make sure that those who are riding the fence have the opportunity to say, you know what? It may not be 15 minutes. I'm just going to do one thing, and they get the chance to do that. In a way, the sense of community and the sense of support, it definitely, I owe a great deal to Rocky because of, he was the guy that first brought me out in this kind of community at Martha Clara all those years ago. So I was a big supporter of his sessions at the loft thing. And
yes.
I'm sorry that they're gone.
Me too. Oh, my gosh.
How long have you been doing?
The plus side is Taps and Corks has got a very nice selection of brew and wine, wouldn't you say, Gianna?
Oh, yes. Yeah, I was having, I had a bottle of Lens. I had some glasses of Lens Chard, and I forget what else I was drinking.
I'm sure you did.
Stop. What?
They also do a thing, and it's kind of fun because I do paint.
I didn't know that.
Enjoy that artistic side of myself. But on Wednesday, starting, I think, the 13th, the 20th, and the 27th, you go there, you get a drink, you go upstairs, and some lady teaches you how to paint.
Huh?
Yeah.
For how much? Like, is there a charge?
Yeah, I think there might be a nominal fee for the, the canvas that you use. And you just show up, and then they'll give you all the supplies. Before Christmas, what they did like a Peanuts theme thing where everybody painted the background, and they were able to place upon them the characters from Charlie Brown, A Christmas Story. Mm. It was adorable, and it's a way to express themselves. The ladies upstairs are having a good time. We're playing music downstairs. It's a really
I gotta say, yeah,
event.
every Wednesday night.
Admit, and again, I owe that to Rocky. He was the one that hooked me up and asked me if I would host the event.
Excellent. And so it's every Wednesday night, 7 to 10,
yes.
Would you say? And very low-key, casual, but so fun. I mean, I gotta say, I would not have wanted to have my first set be anywhere else at any other time. Everyone was so welcoming and so attentive and so polite.
That has something to do with, I think, the feeling of the place, the generosity of the owners. Bernadette, Kevin, they're just so welcoming. Austin is another gentleman, although I only have a phone relationship with Austin. The few times I've spoke with them, just friendly people. It's almost like Rocky's venue in that you feel like you're going into somebody's home.
Right.
They always make you feel welcome. And as the host of the event, I want everybody to feel welcome.
Well, you did that,
and we have people who have come as far as East Meadow to perform there, Sag Harbor, Southampton.
Right.
And I'm touched by that. Some of these guys make money playing professionally, and yet they come down to my little open mic and they'll play a 15-minute set, or they'll join. You saw that last night.
Right, we saw Doug. We saw Doug and Doug.
And they say, can you help me out here? And Chris Hurley was great on the harmonica last night, and Doug Attridge, Marty comes down from the Who Are Those Guys, Tom Daly, his wonderful wife, Bernice, is now testing the waters of her keyboard skills. So, and if I neglected to name any of the regulars, forgive me. It's just, come on down. You're going to feel like that lost family member.
And that's
welcoming to see you. We're happy to hear you. Just come on down. I suggest we get, now, what is your name? Are you Bruce?
Yes, I am.
We got to get him to come down.
Oh, yes.
Why?
Oh, Bruce has to
I was
come
made
in.
For radio. I wasn't made for...
I'm going to do... Because I'm going to do comedy. You have to come and support me sometime.
God.
Bruce, you have to come... I'll talk about you. I'll make jokes about you.
Like, you're going to be the first one to ever do that.
Yeah, I'm not saying I'm going to be the first. I'm just going to say, like, I'm going to do it to entice
like
you
your
to come.
Mother, I have children. Like your
Leave
mother...
Her mother. Out of your mouth, sir.
Like your mother,
I
have experienced my children turning on me viciously in public.
How many children do you have?
Three.
Oh, good luck to you.
Good luck to you.
I met my accountant the other day, and I didn't recognize him because there were no kids hanging on him.
Yeah, well, but they come back. Don't worry.
Oh, yeah, especially in the Great Recession. They come back and they don't leave.
So this is Wednesday night, starting at what time?
Wednesday, sign up is around 6:30, but people start showing up around 7. It lasts until 10, but really we go over the 10 o'clock hour. Sometimes people jam later, and I welcome all of that. It's just a really great place. I hope to see you there, Bruce, okay?
Thank you. I will at some point appear there.
Thank you so much, GP. It was an absolute pleasure. Thank you for coming on the show. We'll be back next Thursday.